In today's video, you're going to learn how to set up a Google business profile like this one, so you can attract customers who are looking for a business like yours on Google Search and Google Maps in 2023. To make this tutorial as simple as possible, I have organized it into chapters so that even if you don't watch all of it today, you can easily come back to it later and start from where you left off using the timestamps on the timeline of the video. If you're ready, let's get started. The very first thing you need to do before setting up a Google business profile is to create a Google account. A lot of you watching this tutorial may already have a Google account in the form of a Gmail address. Although you can use it to set up a Google listing for your business, I would recommend you create a dedicated Google account for your business instead. This allows you to keep your personal email and your Google business listing separate. To create a brand new Google account, head over to accounts.google.com. From there, click on the Create an Account link and add your first and last name and create a memorable email address for your account. I usually use the name of the business or something close enough. Today, I'm going to create a Google business listing for a fictitious plumbing company called Smashing Plumbing Limited, so I'll use this as an address. Set up a password, then follow the few extra steps until you get to the page confirming you've now created your Google account. Head over to google.com/business and sign in with the Google account you created. It will take you to this screen, which is where the Google business profile setup process starts. Google may already have created a listing for your business based on the information it can find on the web. To find out if it has, start typing the name of your business in the business name field. If your business is listed in the auto suggestion results, select it. You will get a message informing you someone else is the owner of the profile. Just click on the Request Access button and follow the process to request the ownership. If there is no existing profile for your business, just click on Continue and move on to the next step. At this stage, you'll be prompted to specify your business type. You can choose between three options, which are not mutually exclusive. For example, you can be a local store or a business with a physical location that also does online retail. Alternatively, you could be a service business that only visits customers at their home. The choice is yours. Depending on which option you choose, the information you'll need to provide will vary. In the next chapter, I'm going to cover the two most common business types, which will be A. You manage a physical location and customers can visit you in person, or B. You are a service business and only visit customers at their home. If you operate from a physical location like a store or office customers can visit, you should select the local store option. Typical examples of local businesses with a physical location would be dentists, beauty salons, restaurants, lawyers, only to name a few. Once your profile is verified, your location will be represented on Google Maps with a map pin. Once you are done, click on Next. The next step is to choose a business category. In the business category field, start typing what you think your business category should be. Google will suggest the best possible match. Once you're done, click on Next. On the next screen, add the physical address of your location, then click Next. Then add the phone number customers should use to get in touch with your business. If you have a website, add the address to the website field, then click on Next. This will take you to a Google Business Profile verification step where you'll need to confirm your business operates at the address you specified. Before going through the verification process, let's now look at our second business type, which is for those of you who visit customers at their homes. Typical example would be electricians, plumber, locksmith, pest control, and so on. Once verified, Google will highlight the boundaries on Google Maps of the areas where your business operates as opposed to a map pin. Select the service business option, then click on Next. On the next screen, in the business category field, start typing what you think your business category should be. Google will suggest the best possible match. Once you're done, click on Next. On the next page, add the areas where your business operates. You can add up to 20 service areas by specifying cities and postcodes. Don't add areas that are further than about 2 hours of driving time from where your business is based. is against Google's guidelines. Once you are done, click on Next. Add the phone number customers should use to get in touch with your business and your website address if you have one, then click Next. The next prompt is just an interstitial page Google uses for you to agree to terms and conditions. Just click on Continue. This will take you to a Google Business Profile verification step, which is what we will cover in the next chapter. Whether you've chosen to add an address or selected service areas to your profile, you should all by now have reached the verification process page. To ensure your Google Business Profile is genuine and authentic, Google will prompt you to go through one of the several verification methods available. One of the simplest verification methods is done by phone. All you need to do is enter your business phone number and click on Next. You will receive an automated message that contains a code that you can use to verify your business. Another method you might come across is video verification, which is something Google has been using a lot more over the past few months to help combat spam. To use this method, you'll need a mobile device with a camera and produce a video in one continuous recording that includes your current location, some of your equipment, and proof of management. This one will take some planning, so if this is the option that's available to you, you may need to click on the Verify Later link. You can also be given the option to verify your business via a postcard. Google will send you a postcard like this one that includes a 5-digit code number. Once the card arrives, you'll need to sign into your profile, then enter the code. Other options such as mail verification, live video calls, or even instant verification via Search Console are available, but Google decides which verification method you will be given. If you need help verifying your profile, head over to the Google support documentation that breaks down each and every method in detail. You can find the address in the description of this video. For now, I'm going to click on Verify Later so we can move on to the next step. Depending on the business category you have chosen, Google might suggest a range of common services your business provides. If you feel some of them don't apply to you, simply click on them so they won't be added. On the other hand, if you want to add specific services that are not listed, click on the Add Custom Service link and start adding them to your profile. If you don't see this page, don't panic. It's just that Google is unable to suggest any relevant services for your business, in which case you'll be automatically directed to the next step, which is what we are going to cover in the next chapter. Time to add opening hours to your profile. Although this step is a very straightforward one, it's important to note you must display accurate business hours so customers know when they can visit or contact you. Make sure you keep this information up to date and edit it when it changes, for example, during public holidays. Do not be tempted to show you are open 24 hours if you are not. It is against Google's guidelines. Once you're done, click on Next. Prospective customers who find your Google listing can get in touch with your business by messaging you directly from it. When creating a Google business for the first time, this messaging feature will be turned on by default. Although it can drive additional leads to your business, it is important you answer messages in a timely manner. Otherwise, Google will automatically turn this option off. It will also prevent negative customer experience. If you feel you can't commit to answering text messages from your profile, just toggle this option off. If you think you can leave it on, then click on Next. You should now have the ability to add a description to your profile. If you don't know what to write, think of your description as the equivalent of the About Us page on your website. You can include a brief summary of what you offer, what makes you different from your competition, a little bit about your history, and whatever else you think might be useful for your prospective customers. Don't stuff your description with keywords in a hope it will help your listing rank. It doesn't work. You have 750 characters to play with, so make the most of them. When you're done, click on Next. Last but not least, add photos to your listing.
Needless to say, photos are a great way of visually representing your business. They will help your listing stand out in search results and attract more clicks. Photos can also help you showcase your products or services as well as your physical location if you have one. Don't use photos from free stock photo websites as they don't look genuine. Use original photos that truly represent your business. Don't make this a one-off exercise and make sure you add photos to your profile regularly. Once you're done adding images, click on Next. After this step, Google will offer you some free advertising credits, which you can skip until you get to the final screen. From there, just click on Continue. Congratulations, your Google Business profile is now created. You should have been redirected to a Google search screen that looks similar to this one, which includes a brief summary of your listing along with a dashboard you can use to update and enhance it. For most of you, it's unlikely your listing will be verified just yet, so remember to do this as quickly as you can. You will be able to do this by clicking on the Get Verified option. While waiting for the verification to go through and to hit the ground running when your listing gets verified, I suggest you build it up further as we've only covered the basic setup today. Watch this video to learn how you can optimize your listing to maximize your visibility and attract more customers.